Hey everyone, this is Kevin from thechesswebsite.com. Today we're going to be going over the Winawer variation in the French defense. French being one of the more popular chess openings with e4, e6, and then d4, d5, striking the center of the board. White usually responds with knight c3. This is the main line defending this pawn in the center of the board on e4. And bishop to b4, this is the Winawer variation. We're going to go over all the main lines that you will see. E5 is pretty common here. If they want to exchange with the exchange variation, they can do that. Pawn a3, just attacking the bishop as well. Knight to e2, one option. Bishop to d3, defending the pawn, that's going to be important. Or you could just see bishop to d2. They know that the knight's being pinned down right now, and so maybe they want to defend with their bishop. All of those moves are going to be better than something like knight to f3, because this knight on c3, as we talked about, defending the pawn, but really that's all that's hanging between the pawn taking here. And since this knight's being pinned down to the king by this bishop here, it needs an extra defender, because after a move like knight to f3, then the pawn can simply take here on e4. This is going to be extremely bad for white. Black's going to be up in material. Same thing with the normal bishop to e2 move. Pawn can just take right here. The knight can't recapture. It's being pinned down. There is one caveat, and that's why we're going to go over that, and that's knight to e2. That is a variation where, yes, the pawn should be taking here, but white's able to get that material back. So we are going to start with the main line, and that is white continuing with pawn to e5. After e5, black is going to play c5. Just trying to strike this pawn structure in the center of the board for white. And white has a few options as far as how they want to respond. The main line is going to be pawn to a3. And many places will say that the main line for black would continue with bishop takes on c3. And then the pawn's going to recapture. And then maybe knight to e7. This is not the preferred way that I like to play. I think it's not as easy to play from black's perspective, and I think you have a lot more fighting chances if you choose a different move, and that is after pawn to a3, actually to take the pawn here on d4. And the reason for that is breaking up this pawn center for white is crucial when you are attacking with the French defense. So let's look at some of the options that they have here. One of them would be to take the bishop here on b4. That's going to be completely fine. Go ahead and take with your pawn if they want to recapture here. Then usually queen to c7. This is attacking both the pawn here on e5, also the pawn right here. They could play knight to f3, defending this pawn right here. You could say knight c7 or knight c6 here, attacking the pawn. You definitely have some options. If they want to bring their bishop down b5, pinning down our knight, that's completely okay. We could bring our bishop to b7. If they want to exchange, that's completely okay with us. This is a very good setup for black. Good pawn structure here. You can look at the pawns. They're not that great for white. All of a sudden, white has a very good game in the French defense. Another move, instead of the pawn taking on b4, you could see the queen get involved. So pawn takes and then queen to g4. Many players, when they face off against the French defense, they are prepared to bring their queen down here. Usually the queen doesn't come down, get this aggressive to g4, because black usually has their knight on f6. It's a very common move for black to play, but you can see that's not going to be the case in the French, because usually the French ends up with the pawn here on e5. And so if the knight's going to be moving, it's more coming to e7. So there's opportunity for the queen to attack this king side of the board. But the queen can't take right away. The pawn's going to recapture for black here. If it were to come down, that would be a disaster. The pawn takes here. That's a discovered attack now with the bishop attacking the king here. So have to defend that. Pawn takes the bishop, and then queen on a1 after the capture. So that's not going to be a good plan for white. Another option that white has, and one of the reasons I like to take with the pawn instead of the bishop, is if they take with their queen, That's going to be completely okay as well. Continue to take with the pawn here. They could recapture with their queen. Queen comes up here to c7. Now all of a sudden you look at this very good pawn structure for black here. This pawn's hanging out here. It's an isolated pawn right now. And then from white's perspective, he has kind of a pawn hanging out here, isolated pawn. And from black's perspective, he can develop like normal and have a very good game from here. So that's what happens if they play that pawn to a3 early on. Another alternative you may see is bishop d2. People do not like having their pieces being pinned down, so just bring your bishop here. Says, yeah, if you want to take, I will recapture. Black's going to play knight e7. This is really the only place you're going to be bringing your knight. Can't come to f6, as you can really see that. And this really can get your knight involved into the game how you want it to. This is a great outpost here on f5. He's not really going to be kicking this off with his pawns because he's not playing pawn g4 probably. So this is a great square where it eventually leads to the knight getting involved into the game. Now they have a couple options. If they want to play knight to f3, trying to defend the center of the board, I would still go ahead and take. Capturing these pawns in the center of the board is just so crucial to a solid French attack. I think that's definitely the way to go. Now, if they want to retake with their knight, I think this is completely fine. I'd still take black's position in this setup. Now, instead of knight to f3, maybe now they play pawn a3. I feel like it's always good to know what to do if you see the common moves like a3 here. I'd go ahead and capture. If they want to recapture, I'd play knight c6, and the reason for that, yes, you are giving up a pawn in material, but the reason you can do that is because the next move, and it's very crucial, if you miss it, you're not going to have as great of a game, and that's pawn to d4, and that's attacking the bishop. So after the bishop moves, because it's being defended by both the knight and the queen right here, then you have a couple options. You could, one, go ahead and take the knight here on e5, and they have no central pawns. That's an option. Or you could play queen d5 is what I really like. Very aggressive. You're now attacking both of the pawns. You have multiple options. Now you could play knight to e5. So black has a much more aggressive stance, where usually in the French defense, most people think of white having this strong attack, all their pawns lining up on the king side, and they just start forcing a strong attack on the king side. No, no, no. We're going to squash that with the way we're going to attack with the French defense. Now, instead of the bishop coming to b2, another option that you could see from white is just go ahead and take the pawn here on c5. I think that's completely fine for black. Knight to e7 is going to be the move. And there's just no real good way for them to hold on to this pawn right here, because you can always just come back and capture it, and then you still have two central pawns. They do not. If they want to try to hold on to it with queen d4, which they probably wouldn't, but then you're just going to play knight c6, forcing the queen back. You're going to eventually take the material. If they try to hold on to it with their bishop, well, now you activate your knight. Knight to f5, attacking the bishop. If they want to try to come here, d4, 1, yes, you could go ahead and take it. But you could also just play queen to a5. This is double barreling here on the pin, and also another attacker on the c5 square. White's just not going to be being able to hold on to that material. So those are the main variations that you'll see after they play that e5 move. Now, if we come back to the initial setup in the Winawer variation, they don't have to play e5. And so another option that you would see is the exchange variation. It doesn't happen all that often, but sometimes players don't like playing the French. And so they'll say, I'll just go ahead and exchange the material in the center of the board. Go ahead and take with your pawn right here. Nothing too crazy is going to happen in this. You could see knight to f3 defending the pawn right here. You're just going to continue with normal knight to c6. They're defending, you're attacking. Maybe bishop down here to d3. Knight to f6, which is not something you commonly are doing in the French defense. But since the pawn's not here on e5, you can easily come knight f6, castle on the king side. Both sides are going to be completely fine. If instead you see something like Bishop coming down to b5, sure, knight c6. If they want to capture, that's fine. You now have the bishop pair. They don't. Yes, you do have double pawns here on the c-file, but it's very easy for you later on to play something like c5. You can easily get rid of the double pawns. Usually they're not going to do this, but some options that you'll see in the game if you come across the exchange variation. Now, instead of the exchange, you could see just pawn a3 right away, attacking the bishop. This is not nearly as good for white, so if you're looking at different moves, or even if you're playing as white, just know that e5 is definitely stronger. That's why it's more in the main line. But some people, they like to say, if you're pinning down my piece, I want to attack that right away. Go ahead and take right here on c3, because after they take, you can go ahead and take with your pawn right here on e4, because that is the threat that they have. Now, we talked about this in an earlier variation. They still have queen g4. And I would recommend in this spot to go ahead and play knight to f6. Yes, if they want to go ahead and take material right here on g7, that's just something you're going to have to learn to play against, because you can chase them around. Rook to g8. Both the pawns are defended, one by the knight, one by the king here. And this rook's also defended by the knight. So you're going to chase the queen around right here. And then eventually you could play queen g6. You do have an active board state. Eventually, if you wanted to castle on the queen side, you could even do that. But this is a position you may see yourself in. It doesn't happen all that often. Sometimes they'll just give you that pawn on e4, recognize they made a huge mistake, try to do something else. You can see they can't come to f3, make some further mistakes. You can develop your board state as normal and have a pretty easy game. If they do get their queen involved into the game, just be prepared to play on this board setup. The next variation is knight to e2, and we've already talked about Black's threat right away is taking on e4, and if you don't have a way to defend this because the knight can't capture, it's being pinned down right now, you're up a pawn in material. But this is the one exception, because they're going to be able to get that material back, because after a3, there's no way to hold on. Meaning, if you try to bring your bishop back, okay, well, that's going to be out of the way. Then they could just take this pawn right here. You're no longer pinning down that knight. If you decide, okay, a3, and then you want to go ahead and capture the material, which is what you should be doing, then knight to c3, and now you are going to lose this pawn. And I would not recommend trying to hold on to it with something like f5. It just really messes up your pawn structure right here. It's just not worth it. So if they do play this, I would instead play c6. This does attack their pawn right now. You have both your queen and your knight attacking that. So you could see e3, and then knight to f6. You can see that adds another layer of protection right now. And then maybe bishop down to f6, trying to pin down the material. You can see this is a mistake, because then the queen can just come up and take this material right here. Now, this is important, because if we come back to the very beginning of this spot, I initially said, if they take, don't play knight to f5. Now, some people maybe look at this and say, why not play knight to f6? This does defend this material. The reason is bishop down to g5. The knight has the same problem that this knight on c3 has. It's pinned down. It cannot defend this material. And there's no way to really attack any material here from Black's perspective. That's very different than if you start with c3, as I'm recommending, or c6, excuse me, attacking this pawn. Now, if they want to defend it, they defend with their bishop. You bring your knight out here to f6. And if they want to come down and pin the material, well, now you have this knight here on c6, the attacking material. I'm not saying they will come down and pin the material, but it's always important to know what piece to move in the correct order, because now you've put them in a really tricky spot. And so while they're trying to get this material back, they really can't, at least with these move variations, because you have the upper hand. You have both of your knights that are active in the game. So that's what happens if they play knight to g2. Go ahead and take with your pawn right here, but just be prepared to give that material back. Next variation we're going to look at is bishop to d3. Knowing that the threat is the pawn taking on e4, you may see the bishop come and defend that pawn. I would still capture. Gobbling up material in the center of the board is the key to success in the French defense, in my opinion. Now, the bishop could take. That's completely fine. Knight to f6 here because the pawn's not going to be on e5. Attacking the bishop on e4. Depending on where it goes, couple options. Bishop to f3, that's fine. You have three variations of how you could play. I'll give you my recommendation. But c5, if you're one of those people that likes to exchange queens and then play that game, not my cup of tea, but a lot of people like to play that. If you want to play more of a safe route, castle on the king side, you have that option as well. I usually just like to get more material involved into the game. Knight to c6 here. If they want to take right here, yes, you do have double pawns here on the c-file. But like we talked about before, playing pawn to c5, you can easily get those back. And now you do have a bishop pair, and you can easily open up this board state. So that's usually what I'm opting for. If we come back, if they don't play knight or bishop to f3, they could play bishop to g5, pinning down that knight. That's also an option. Knight to d7 now is a very good move. You could castle on the king side. All in all, this is going to be a very good game from black. You can see so many variations depending on where black goes. You have a really strong setup, and they do not control the center of the board, which they like to do in the French defense. The last variation we're going to look at, instead of the bishop coming to d3, is bishop d2. You pin down a piece. They like to defend it with their bishop. They don't want to have double pawns, which makes perfect sense. In this case, this is not a very good move from white. This is falling under that category of, yeah, let's go ahead and take that pawn right here. And the reason this is bad is, okay, now the knight's not pinned down. If they want to take, that's fine. But the queen taking on d4 is just detrimental to them. This is attacking so many different things out there. If they want to come back, knight to c3, that's fine. Knight to f6, you can continue your development as normal. Now, the better move for them after you take this pawn is to play knight to e2. But that's a really tough move for them to find. After that move, then knight to f6, another piece attacking or defending the square here on e4. Maybe now they attack, you exchange material right here, and then knight c6. This is, you have much better active pieces in the game. All in all, I would definitely be taking black in this position. So this is the Winawer variation, one of the more common variations you'll run up against in the French defense, because you're just going against the main lines that white is playing. So if you're new to the French defense, or you're curious from white's perspective, what are some of the lines that you could see? Hopefully this was a good introduction to the Winawer, and you have much more confidence going into the French defense because it is a very, very sound defense. It gives you a very good attacking options if you are black. Thanks again for watching the video. I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm going to have a lot more variations of the French defense coming out, so make sure you check out thechesswebsite.com for more updates of the French defense.